Hello, everybody. I don't have my hands on because I am wearing gloves again. This is what I'm eating. It's not the regular ramen. It's actually the more dry sauce type of ramen. And it's the double the spicy. It's only been sitting here for like less than a minute. Let's add this. It's so picturesque now. It looks happy now. Oh boy, all right. So we have the flaming hot Mountain Dew. That's actually real. When I saw the announcement for it, I thought it was fake. You're bold enough to buy it, now it's time to try it. Oh, it is red orange. There we go. It smells spicy. It makes your nose burn. I think I might have poison gassed myself just now. All right, let's take a sip here. It's actually spicy. It's in between like a Frank's Red Hot Cinnamon and I don't know, regret? So the first question I'm gonna read off is, what is the downside, if any, is there to VTubing? With VTubing, there are a variety of things. First of all, regular streaming in itself has a lot of stresses, and then you're adding on having software running in the background that's like gonna make your computer run really slowly. And then you have a lot of technical things that can be a lot harder to add on. Plus, of course, there's the pressures of making updates to your model. It also attracts a specific audience. Yeah, the downside for it, I think, is that you have an additional resource that you now have to manage. Why are you torturing yourself for us? I did a charity stream, and this was one of the rewards for hitting a certain goal. All right, let's try the first bite here, okay? Shall we? That first initial bite was definitely quite spicy. It's not that bad. You do feel the spiciness like in your chest though. Next one. So as a family-friendly streamer, do you feel difficulty in doing collabs, especially when a majority of content creators on Twitch go to the E+18 speech patterns? I'm fine with doing collabs with people that have 18 plus stuff. Like if they make jokes that are directed towards me and want me to interact back, then I probably will PG-13 it. Like it's my own choice to do family-friendly and I'm not gonna limit my friends from doing that. I have found that a lot of my friends that if I'm gonna collab with them, they do tend to start saying heck instead. How are you able to manage a social life as a full-time streamer? Well, good news. A lot of my friends are streamers as well. And even before doing VTubing, I don't socialize too much outside. I have my fashion group, but we just pretty much hang with that. I don't tend to go out looking to socialize with people too often. Is the most spicy thing you've ever eaten? No. Are your lips hot? Yes. Ha, what's the spiciest thing you've ever eaten? We went to an Indian food place one time, and one of my friends ordered the spiciest thing on the menu. It was a vegetarian one, thankfully. My lips are burning. So the hard thing about this one, it makes your spit spicy. So my tongue is just like unhappy. Was VTubing something you wanted to do for a long time, or did you discover it and try it? When did you decide you were really committed? I had seen Kizuna Ai first. I thought she was really entertaining. I liked to watch. And then once it started becoming more accessible for people, I started looking into it. I really liked it and wanted to try it, but didn't have any dreams of being like good at it or anything. On a scale of 1 to 10, how spicy? With 10 being the spiciest thing I've ever had, I'd probably put this at a solid 7. I'm trash at socializing. How do you get the energy to be so interactive with chat? A lot of it's a lot of practice, because I did teaching. And with teaching in Japan, if you were sad or if you didn't have a lot of energy, the students would complain about it and then you get talked to by the manager. Who inspired you to start streaming? I didn't have one specific person. I guess maybe Markiplier, but he's more of a Let's Player. He does more YouTube stuff. Hot. Which WN is your favorite? You can only name one. I don't actually read a lot of web novels, so cannot answer that question. What was your favorite restaurant while you were living in Japan? Mine was definitely Koko Ichibanya Curry House. My favorite is Onyasai. Onyasai is a shabu shabu restaurant. They have all you can eat shabu shabu, and you can choose what kind of broth that you want, and they have a vegetarian all you can eat option, so I really like it a lot. What's vegetarian shabu shabu like? Well, there's mochi, there's like mochi cheese things that you can put in, a whole bunch of different vegetables. With the broths that are available, I usually like the soy milk broth, and it's a savory soy milk. It's really good. What is your advice, aside from keeping a schedule, for those who want to start streaming? What kinds of games should they start with? How prepared should they be from the first stream? What a well-rounded question. That's a hard question to answer with games, because it really depends on what type of games you enjoy playing and ones that you think are interesting to watch. I specifically like to play games on stream that I can talk to the audience with. Does that look like a hefty portion to eat in one go? I'm gonna regret this. Okay. I find Mexican food spicy, like punches you and then it keeps going. This one, it hits you pretty strong for the first couple of minutes and then it fades to a pleasant burn. What's your favorite food and drink combo? I really like a nice veggie burger and a pale ale. I really like that. That's a good combo. You think you'll ever drop the PG-13 restriction? I'm not sure. I've considered it, but then I've also had people who have been like, hey, I really enjoy the fact that you have PG-13 for your content because there's not a lot of streamers that have that kind of rating for it. And Panther's turned on Nyan time. All right, Nyan. I actually did have the idea before Nyan of having like an alternate stream Nyan with like a whole different name and a different options and everything Nyan, different avatar as well Nyan, where it wouldn't be PG-13 Nyan. Then I realized that y'all also know how to use video editing stuff and you're totally going to just take clips from that Nyan and then edit them in Nyan, kind of like what people have done with like Genie and Robin Williams. I did not drop a single F-bomb until I was in university Nyan because I didn't see the point of it Nyan. All of my friends swore Nyan. I was a big fan of more descriptive insults Nyan. Like, I don't know if you saw, I was on a Rant Cafe and I told Nux to uninstall his brain because like those kinds of things, I had a lot more entertainment from that Nyan as opposed to just like dropping curse words at them, right Nyan? How's curse words on Japanese? So the thing with Japanese curse words is that they're not really curse words, it's just impolite ways of saying you. The thing with that, right Nyan, is that when you have somebody in Japanese says teme kono yaro kind of thing like that, right Nyan, kono yaro means this like impolite word for you. Can you imagine if you're in the middle of like watching, I don't know, Berserk, and the subtitles say impolite you, you derogatory, right Nyan? That's what it would be Nyan. What's your favorite game at the moment? Nyan. Noita is really fun, right Nyan? Dark Souls 3? I'm still thinking about it, Nyan. I really like Minesweeper a lot. You make one mistake, you don't get to retry, Nyan. There isn't a save point, Nyan. You don't get to go back and fix it, Nyan. You're done, Nyan. I am more than halfway through this, Nyan. I'm gonna eat another really big bite and regret it for a bit. This is how much is left. We're gonna finish it, all right? Oh, milk.
Congrats on finishing the spicy challenge. It's over, right?
We're just gonna be in pain for a bit, okay? Do you still go to school? No, I graduated. I have 2 bachelor degrees. What is something you absolutely hate? I hate when there are people that are hassling staff that have absolutely no control over a situation. The only time when I'm okay with people being a jerk is on like phone to like quote unquote staff people is if it's a scammer on the phone. When I get a phone call, a scammer phone call, and there's a real person on the other end, I don't hang up. Oh no. There's a saying that Dad DM has, which I tend to use for when I'm like looking online at things that are obviously meant to entice you into responding, which Dad DM's saying is, well, don't wrestle with a pig in the mud because you'll get dirty and the pig's gonna like it. But when there's a scammer on the phone, I'm wrestling with the pig. I am going to go as long as possible to waste their time. Like, I have definitely done the, oh, I'm so sorry. I know you just went through your whole entire spiel here. I'm not the owner of the home. I'm just a caretaker. The owner just came home. I'm gonna pass the phone back over to her. Is that all right? And then the person on the other end is like, oh yeah, of course, that's fine. And then I just like hand the phone back to myself and go, hi, moshi moshi, doustan desu ka? And then you hear the person presumably cuss you out because they swap to a different language and they sound very upset. And then they hang up. That's what I like to do. What's the most money you've wasted on a stupid purchase? Not the Mountain Dew again. Okay, okay. Depending on your opinion on things, could be a stupid waste of money. But this is something that I've spent a decent amount of money on. It's so good! When are you gonna add the ear petting feature permanently to your stream? So I uploaded a video that showed me touching my ear, and I was like, oh my gosh, my ear! And that is using a different tracking program, and it's not reliable enough for me to be able to get my hands to touch my ear each time. Let's see, how long did you play around with the idea of streaming, and how nervous were you those first few streams? It didn't take too much for me to play around with the idea of it, so pretty much my plan of attack with pretty much anything I do is watch a lot of videos on YouTube about it, and then try to do it myself. It took me a bit to figure out how to use OBS and how it worked. The nervousness didn't kick in too much. When you're looking at your Twitch back view, you can see how long your session is going, you can see the total views on your channel, you can see how many followers you have, your bitrate, your subscribers, your sub points, and you also have a viewers one. And if you click on those buttons, it turns off the view. And I have, from the start, had that current viewers turned off because it made me extremely nervous. What's your favorite Nendo? Ooh, hard to say. This is probably one of my favorite Nendoroids.
gosh.
He's just so detailed. I have all of the Overwatch Nendoroids so far. Here, would you like to see another questionable girl DM owned item? On DM, why do you have this? It even has the tail! Well, I didn't spend money on this. One of my friends printed it for me. What's something you love to doing besides streaming and cooking? Dressing up. Do you have any tips for new VTubers? Get familiar with your software. With your streaming software, with your avatar software. Streaming and presenting on its own is going to be stressful with all the things that you're going to need to balance. And if you know how to fix something that goes wrong, that takes all that stress away. How much do you actually like cats? I like cats quite well. I've never had a cat. I would like to have a cat someday, but Dad DM is deathly allergic. What's your favorite cartoon from your childhood? I didn't get a chance to watch it too often because we didn't have, like, cable and such, but Danny Phantom. Kind of specific, but how do you mount your Ultra Leap? This is how I have my Ultra Leap set up. So this is my hand tracking. This is an Ultra Leap. It's currently reading something as being my hand. It's not there right now, hands, but okay. It has holes on the sides, so I just wear it like that around my neck. So I just have elastic here. So sometimes when you hear me say, oop, I forgot my hands, it's because I didn't put these on. Yes, there have been a couple of times that I've almost clotheslined myself. Let's see. This is as far away as I can pull this. That's how long the cable is. There have been times that I've almost clotheslined myself with this. What is your favorite kind of tea? Depends on the season. I really like, for summertime at least, I can say 100%, I like Mugicha. Mugicha is barley tea. I really like barley tea a lot. If you don't mind, what characters have you cosplayed in the past? D.Va, Team Rocket Grunt, Raftalia, Ana, Shrike Ana, Overwatch, Chippo. I'm trying to think of any others. Pre-COVID, I was working on a Tanjiro and I was working on a King Mickey from Kingdom Hearts. Pandemic happened and I haven't worked on cosplay since. Oh, I also did Bubble Tea May. How do you get out of bed when you really, really don't want to? Well, before you go to bed, drink water. What is your wisdom? No matter how much you don't feel like it, brush your teeth before you go to bed. Which country would you still like to visit? I've been to Korea, but I only was there for a week and it was for a business trip. So I would really like to go back to Korea or vacation. What's the appeal of anime, Japan, and those kind of things? Bright flashing colors, I think. I think the other part of it is kinds of stories and tropes aren't necessarily the same types of ones that you are raised with in your own culture. So seeing that presented in a very bright, imaginative seeming way with a whole different sect of mythologies to take from makes it really interesting, I feel like. Would you do a vacation in Japan after living there for a while? Yes, in fact, I've been planning to go back to Japan, but Japan is closed. If you could master a language perfectly, what would it be? Probably Chinese. What is a skill you would like to learn? I think it would be really cool to learn like editing techniques for stuff, like learn how to use After Effects well. I think that would be really cool. Favorite movie, as in like movies that I'm fine to rewatch at any given moment, is The Princess Bride. Is there any ritual to keep yourself cheered up if you feel gloomy? It depends. Sometimes having some time to just chill and like play games with friends or watch some soothing YouTube videos in the background are things that cheer me up. Sometimes I just feel like garbage and I want to be sad for a bit. And so when that happens, I will usually pick a series that's got like a tragedy tag on it or watch like purposefully sad videos. That's normally what I would do because I know that it's going to pass eventually. Like I let my friends know that I'm feeling like garbo and that I'll be better in a bit, but pretty much. Do you have a favorite photographer? There's a photographer that color grades their photos to look like scenes out of animes. And they live in Japan. They are just really nice to look at. Yes, Akine Koko! That's the photographer, Akine Koko. Yes, 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 Akine Koko. What is the most dangerous situation you were in besides the cult story? So when I was born, I was not breathing. That's probably the most dangerous situation I've ever been in. I was born and I was purple. And if not for modern medicine and the wonders of the cesarean section, then I would not be alive because the umbilical cord was wrapped around my neck twice. And if Mom DM had tried to have me the normal way, I would not have been in a good situation. So that's probably the most dangerous situation that I have been in total. Spice Tolerance DM is true. I definitely had a few moments here and there with this, yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 98, 99, 100 headbats taken care of. Pop-a-da-pop. I am going to continue to sip oat milk throughout the night and hope that my stomach does not hate me too much when I go to bed tonight. So I'll see you all later. Have a good one. Bye-bye.